Good afternoon. Welcome to Flower Fun with Tammy. I had a photographer friend come by today and ask me to throw a little bouquet together for her with flowers that she'd purchased. Unfortunately, all she brought me was just flowers, no greenery. So I went around my yard and found some greenery. And what I'm gonna do is I've already started making the little bouquet. Unfortunately, the flowers that she brought are not the prettiest of flowers, but we're gonna make do with what we've got. She's got a photo shoot later this afternoon, so she's gonna use them and it'll get thrown away. So I'm gonna add some greenery to it and a ribbon and just show y'all how that's done real quickly. So I just went to some trees that are in my yard by the pond and found different types of greenery. And I'm just gonna cut some of those and try to, some of it's not so pretty, some of it's seen its better days, so we'll just clip off the ones that look really bad. Try to bend this and make it more of a little drop. Sometimes you just have to make do with what you can find on hand when you get asked to do something like this at the last minute. Had this been planned out, I would have a lot more options because I could go to market and try to find some things that we could use. Try to cut a little bit of these off the bottom before I stick it in here. Not sure that I like that one either. So we're just gonna keep adding till it feels right. Sometimes you just gotta find the right piece, and it takes you a minute to find the right piece, especially when you're working with natural foliage out of the yard. I could have went with magnolia leaves. If my dad wasn't home, I'd have probably took some of his grapevine, but I didn't want to cut his grapevine while he was home. He might fuss a little. This is starting to rain. I hope our bridal shoot does not get rained out tonight. Let's see here. She wanted this to kind of look as natural as possible. And I'm trying to make that happen. So we're gonna just go ahead and cut this off so we can get it bent and put back in some water until she gets here. Not sure what happened there, but starting to pick up. I think we're going to get us an afternoon storm. So We want some movement in it, and that's what we've got is some movement. We can even pull these out just a little. So. And then what we'll do is we're going to cover up the greenery. So. Do is we'll start at the bottom. We're going to hold our ribbon. We're going to cover up all the greenery. We're going to go around. When you're using white ribbon, we need to make sure that your hands are clean. Mine probably aren't the cleanest right now with working with this, but hopefully we won't get anything on this ribbon. You just want to pull the ribbon nice and tight. And when you get to the end, we're going to take a pin and we're going to stick it in to the bouquet stems and push up. Always remember to put your pins in and push up. That way the pins do not stick your bridesmaids or your mother of the bride's hands. And we've got one streamer, so we're going to make another. It's getting crazy out here, isn't it? And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna just take the extra streamer that we have. I'm going to take this and tie it above that in a knot. And then I'm going to bring it around to the front where we want the front dangling part, because that's the front of the bouquet. We'll tie it in a double knot here, and then we'll have movement in the front of the bouquet, and then you just finish off your edges. You can do them on an angle, you can cut them into that perfect little V. For this, we're just going to cut them on an angle. And here is your little bouquet with some things from the yard to add some movement and some greenery. If you've liked what you've seen in this tutorial, please press like. If you would like to share, please share. And please subscribe to my channel. Thank you and have a good day.